Yeah, let's now talk about the case of multiple pairwise comparisons. So a scenario where you have a model that you want to compare with many other models that you maybe find published in literature or on GitHub and so forth. So how can we go about that? So assume we have k different models that we will evaluate. If we have if we do a pairwise test on each pair of models, we would then end up with k times k minus 1 divided by 2. So that's all the combinations we could have for k models, which can be quite a large number, and this can become problematic. So usually when we do hypothesis tests, we use a significance level of 0.05 or smaller, but let's say it's 0.05, and that means that if the null hypothesis is true, 5% of the time we reject the null hypothesis, but we make an error when we reject this. So we have a 5% error rate of incorrectly rejecting the null hypothesis. Now, if we do that multiple times, let's say we do this number of tests, let's call this number R, the error rate for wrongly rejecting a null hypothesis would go up to R times alpha. So it's some number smaller than r times alpha, but up to r times alpha in the worst case can be our error rate of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis if all the pairwise null hypotheses were true. So a null hypothesis here would be that there is no substantial or significant difference between a pair of models. So how can we then go about this? One aspect could be we could pick the model with the highest and the lowest performance and just look at those two, but then again this would introduce selection bias. So one way to do that would be, for example, doing a so-called protected procedure. So in other classes we call that a protected procedure. It's like the two-step procedure where we first do an omnibus test across all the different models, whether the model performances are different. And if we find there is a difference in the model performances, we could follow up with pairwise tests. So step one would be conducting an omnibus test under the null hypothesis that there is no difference between the classification accuracies of all models. So we would say that the accuracy of model 1 is equal to accuracy of model 2, accuracy of model 3, and so forth, so that the performances are all equal. And the alternative hypothesis would be that the performances are not equal. However, if we reject the null hypothesis and find that not all the accuracies are equal, we still don't know which models differ. So we can then follow up with these pairwise comparisons post hoc, but we have to be careful to make adjustments for the multiple comparison, because otherwise we would have a very large error rate of falsely rejecting null hypotheses. So just by increasing this error rate, which can be then up to r times alpha. So one test is the omnibus test that we can use. Could be, for example, Cochran's Q test, which is a generalized version of McNemar's test. I was about to show you how that works, but I think it's not super necessary here. It would just take 20 minutes and you won't learn that much useful. You see an equation. So in that case, if you are interested in that, looking at this and reading through this, I have that written up in the lecture notes, so you can read through my lecture notes and get a better idea. But also don't worry about it, I won't ask you about this in the exam. So if I don't cover it in the lecture here, like a topic that is not covered in the lecture, I won't really ask that in the exam. It's just like there are so many interesting things to talk about, but if we start talking about these, we probably won't get to feature selection in next week's lecture. So in that case, let's maybe skip over these interesting but not super interesting topics. So and then once we did the omnibus test, if we fail to reject the null hypothesis that all accuracies are equal, then we are done, we stop. Otherwise, if we reject the null hypothesis that all accuracies are equal, we continue with the pairwise post hoc tests, but we do the adjustments. So for the pairwise tests, we could, for example, use McNemar's test, and as an adjustment, we could use Bonferroni's method, and I don't think I've included it here. But one obvious candidate that you probably heard about in other statistics classes is Bonferroni's method. I think it's a double R, but I'm not sure, which is just dividing the alpha, the significance level, by the number of comparisons. So if my alpha is 0.05, if I have k comparisons, I would, well, let's say we call that r, right? Yeah, r comparisons, we would use for alpha, so we would update alpha by dividing alpha, the original one, by r, and test all the pairwise tests against this one. So if I have 10 comparisons, then I would have alpha level of 0.005. So this would be my adjusted one. Let's call it a prime or something like that. So that would be one method, but of course, yeah, Bonferroni's method also has issues. It can be a little bit conservative, for example, and that's also not ideal. But yeah, again, I have some more details in the lecture notes and some follow-up literature that I recommend if you're interested in that topic. It's not like urgent that you do it now, it's just something you might be interested in reading about more in the future. Okay, so yeah, just what I mentioned before, that's just our formal hypothesis, null hypothesis, that we test that all the accuracies are equal. Okay, so these were just a few words about multiple comparisons, potential issues with that. I have implemented Cochran's Q-test in MLExtend if you want to use it, so if you have multiple models. I just see I also included some more explanation here. So you could actually, if you wanted to, use that from MLExtend if you find a situation where you want to compare multiple models. However, I should also note, while from a statistical standpoint, this is interesting procedure, in machine learning practice, I have actually never seen anyone doing that. So in that case, you may be one of the first people actually doing that if you do that. Because somehow in machine learning, this is not very common. People usually just report prediction accuracies or prediction errors and then just eyeballing them or just ranking them, and that's usually it. Okay, so, but yeah, now you know a little bit more. Now you know that there are also statistical tests for comparisons.